New details of that deadly encounter at the Los Angeles airport, a gunman killing a TSA officer, injuring several others. And this evening, that new picture of the suspect now emerging. Paul Ciancia, seen right here in his high school photo, a schoolmate saying he was a loner in class. And new information about the family man he is alleged to have targeted and killed, TSA agent Gerardo Hernandez. His heartbroken wife saying he was proud to work for the TSA. And in tribute tonight to Agent Hernandez, lights in TSA blue as you approach LAX airport. Meanwhile, inside the terminals, remnants of the chaos, the mountains of luggage left behind by passengers ordered to flee as the shots rang out. Our coverage tonight begins with ABC's David Wright at LAX, where he's been since the start.
Moments before all this, Paul Ciancia arrived at LAX like a passenger, dropped off by someone driving a black Hyundai. The criminal complaint filed Saturday in federal court describes a cold-blooded attack. It says video surveillance showed Ciancia walking up to the TSA checkpoint in Terminal 3, pulling a Smith & Wesson assault rifle out of his bag, and firing multiple shots at point-blank range at a TSA officer. Then it says as he proceeded up the escalator, he looked back at the wounded officer, who in video appeared to move, and returned to shoot the officer again, killing him. The FBI says Ciancia gunned down two more TSA officers as he shot his way through the terminal.
He made a conscious decision to kill multiple TSA employees.
The FBI says his bag contained five magazines full of ammo, along with a handwritten letter signed by Ciancia, addressing the TSA directly, saying he hoped, quote, to instill fear on your traitorous minds. The widow of Gerardo Hernandez, the 39-year-old father of two in the line of fire, read a brief statement to reporters outside their home.
I am truly devastated, and we are all heartbroken, and we'll miss him dearly.
Today, those iconic pillars of light, the symbols of LAX, are lit TSA blue in his honor. Today, things are back to normal here in Terminal 3. Ciancia is in a hospital bed just a few miles away, said to be unresponsive after a gunshot wound to the head. If he ever does regain consciousness, he'll now be facing criminal charges that could carry the death penalty.